As David Letterman prepares to say farewell to his fans with the last show airing this Wednesday, I am putting some local personalities to the test to find out just how well they know this late night legend. Here for some Letterman trivia. Oh my goodness, what a handsome looking panel. It's Giovanni from 92 Pro FM and Brian Mulhern from Cat Country 98.1. Like me, they are self-proclaimed Letterman nerds. Good morning, gentlemen.
Good morning.
Good morning, Brendan.
What a fine-looking group, dressed up.
Brian looks fantastic.
He does, always in that polo.
Get that prescription check, my friend.
All right, well, let's get right to it, gentlemen. We are here, and wouldn't Dave be thrilled with this graphic here?
No. Not even a little
Absolutely mortified.
Well, let's get right to it. Wake the kids, phone the neighbors. Is that what it is? Whoever rings in first will have the first opportunity to answer. You will receive 1 point for a correct answer. You will not be penalized for a wrong answer.
My bell, please.
Test the bell. There you go.
Test mine.
Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. The first question. David Letterman's hometown is what city? Gio.
Gary, Indiana.
Incorrect. Brian, would you like to try?
Indianapolis.
Indianapolis is correct. Well done. Moving along. In the late 70s, before achieving stardom with his own show, Dave was a bit player on the variety show of what female TV comedy legend? Brian.
Mary Tyler Moore.
That is correct.
Wow, he's steamrolling.
Gio, can you hear me?
No.
Have you started this segment yet?
The game has begun. It's 2-0, Brian. Next question. Dave's first foray into show hosting began with his short-lived morning program in 1980. Name this show. Brian.
The David Letterman Show.
David Letterman Show is correct.
You want to go home now?
Is there like a gas leak in here that has affected your ability to focus?
By the way, this is the exact opposite of what happens in the radio rating.
Okay. We got to get to as many of these as we can. Paul Schaefer, Dave's longtime band leader, co-wrote what well-known 1982 song by the weather?
Duh.
Ryan again.
It's Raining Men.
It's Raining Men.
Hallelujah.
Also your ringtone, I heard. next question. Paul is known for being a part of what other long-running late-night show before joining Dave? Right again.
Saturday Night Live
is correct. Here we go, Gio, anytime. You know? Letterman routinely has invited people on to showcase their unusual talents and stunts. Name this classic recurring segment.
Stupid Human Tricks.
That is correct. Oh, my goodness gracious. Was that for the heck of it? Next question.
I'm sensing a late rally from this guy.
I am. Here we go. We have about a minute left. Another early Letterman innovation had Dave reading misprints and odd stories from newspapers. Name this segment.
Oh. Small Town News?
Brian?
Small Town News?
Well, he didn't ring the bell. I think you're going to lose a point for that, Gio. Would you like to guess, even though you now know? We'll give him a point for pity. How does that sound? Gio with one on the board.
My answer is jaywalking.
All right. Headlines, here we go. A Letterman trademark has Dave tossing a blue card through the cityscape behind him, producing what sound effect? Gio?
Water splashing.
That is incorrect. Brian?
Broken glass.
Yes, and in tribute to Dave, here we go. Yeah. Oh, you gotta love that, don't you? Let's try another one, you guys. Longtime Letterman announcer Alan Coulter has what color hair?
Ooh, I think he got
it. Was close. What do you say to the judges? I think it was Brian.
He would be a redhead, a ginger, as they say.
And a bonus follow-up question. Dave's first announcer was named
Bill Wendell.
Bill Wendell! Right. Gio coming through with that last dash at the end. Let's do a couple more. What absurd name did Dave give his production company, which produced and owned The Late Show, Brian?
Worldwide Pants.
That is correct. Ladies and gentlemen, after all of that, aren't you glad you tuned in today to see the Brian Mulhern Letterman domination? Congratulations, my friend. Brian runs away with it 9-2. Gio, I still love you, buddy. For Brian, a parting gift. In true Dave fashion, catch, buddy. It's a canned ham. Enjoy.
Oh, Lord.
That
look
is
at this.
For you.
Wow.
Look at that Rhode Show budget.
That's right. As Dave would say, there are no losers on Letterman Trivia. Gio, this is a late show script not signed by Dave.
Excellent.
Enjoy, buddy.
Perfect.
Gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us.
And the spirit of good sportsmanship.
Congratulations.
Here, you can have this.
He didn't share the canned ham. Well, thank you very much to this good-looking panel. Do not miss David Letterman's farewell episode this Wednesday night. We're going to watch it and cry together. It's right here at 11:35 on WPRI 12.